சென்னையில ரோட்ல இருக்கிறவங்களுக்கு வீடு கொடுங்க.
எடுக்கிறதுக்கான காரணம் உங்ககிட்ட என்ன சொல்றாங்க?
ரோட்ல இருக்கிறவங்க அவங்களுக்கு அசி அசி அவங்க போக போற வரதுக்கு இடத்துக்கு ஆஃபீஸ் வந்தாங்க. அதனால இடத்துல இருக்கிற ஆபீசர் வரதான், அதெல்லாம் நீங்க எடுங்க.
We want to make Chennai as Sigara Chennai. Government of Tamil Nadu, under the leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister, has already declared that in Chennai, the Sigara Chennai 2.0 project will be taken.
It has been 6 months since the Stalin-led DMK formed the government in Tamil Nadu. They have recently launched a project called Sigara Chennai 2.0, aimed at the beautification of Chennai city. Under the project, the government has been evicting people from roadsides and slum areas. This week, around 50 people staying on platforms near Egmont railway station were evicted forcefully. They were not given any prior notification and they have not been given any permanent resettlement place so far. They have now been made to stay in a place on a temporary basis. What has really happened? The news click met the affected people and listened to their concerns.
உப்பு வந்து எங்களுக்கு எதுமே சொல்லல, நாங்க எடுக்குறோம் கொல்றோம், நீங்க வேற இடம் போங்கன்னு ஒரு வார்த்தை கூட சொல்லையா? கடவண்ணு வந்தாங்க, பெட்டியெல்லாம் வாரினாங்க, கொண்டாங்க, வாரினு போயிட்டாங்க. இப்ப பெருமிட்டுக்கு போன்றாங்க ஐயா. நாங்க பெருமிட்டுக்கு நாங்க போக மாட்டோம்ன்றோம். நான் போக மாட்டேன். ஊரு விட்டு ஊரு எப்படி போறது ஐயா? ரிமைண்ட் பில்டிங்ல சிங்கி கற்களமானு குத்துக்குறோம். அவரையும் போய் பார்த்தோம், நல்லா பார்த்து பொங்கலுக்குள்ள ஏற்பாடாயிடும்னு சொல்லிக்கிறாங்க. இவனுங்க வந்து இதாங்கட்டே வந்து அராஜகம் எங்களுக்கு பண்றானுவோ. எங்க வீட்டு பெட்டி, எங்க வீட்டு துணி மணி எல்லாத்தையும் வாரினு போயிடணும். கட்டிக்க துணி இல்ல, போட்டுக்க துணி இல்ல.
என்ன பண்ண போறீங்க?
என்ன பண்ண போறது? நாங்க சாகுனா அவ்வளவுதான். இல்ல நாங்க எல்லாம் கிருஷ்ணால் வாங்கி வச்சு நாங்க ஊத்தின்னு கொளுத்திக்குவோம் ஐயா. வீட குடுங்க, நாங்க போறோம்.
அலாட்மெண்ட் கையில குடுக்கலையா?
குடுக்கல. என் கையில எல்லாம் அத்தரை டேங்குது. ஒட்டு ஐடி நிக்குது, ஆதார் கார்டு இருக்குது, ரேஷன் கார்டு
எடுக்கிறதுக்கு It is only about evicting people, and we should ask the question why that is the case. Why are you not talking about homeless people? Why are you not talking about the housing crisis? Why are you just interested in evicting people? See, then we have to look at it from a kind of a global context, because now, particularly after the neoliberalism and after India opening up its economy, the competition to attract foreign capital is quite huge. And the competition is not between Indian cities and Indonesian cities and Indian cities and other developing country cities. No, the competition is also between the cities within India. This competition between Chennai and Bangalore, this competition between Chennai and Hyderabad, of course, these three cities, like Andhra and the states, Andhra Pradesh, then Andhra Pradesh, now Telangana, and Andhra and Bangalore and Chennai, they are in huge competition to attract foreign capital. There are certain kind of capital which only comes to South India. They don't go to North India except Delhi or Mumbai for some reason. So then you have to show your city something that is like Singapore, something that is like New York, right? Every time when a politician comes and says that, say, Sigara Chennai 2.0, we want to make our city like Singapore. The question that needs to be asked is, why should Chennai look like Singapore? Why can't Chennai be like Chennai? Why it should look like Singapore? What is the point of it, right? It is not just about infrastructure. It is about giving a cosmopolitan character to your city and showing that this city can be something like your first world city. It will have all the facilities like first world city. And people just forget that the first world cities are cities for the rich in the first world cities. You go to New York, you see people who are living in pavements, homeless people are, because that's how the city is constructed, and that is the case with most of the first world cities. So the idea here is also the same, is to evict. So, and also the idea is not about evicting these people from the land. It's not about just resettlement. It's basically evicting a certain kind of poverty in the inner city, right? You are not just evicting those people, you are evicting the entire character that the city is built with. So you are evicting them so that in the inner city, poverty won't be visible. And the poverty is now visible in one particular section. See, the idea of ghetto is not there in Chennai. If you look at Indian cities, we cannot say this is a ghetto. Except one or two places like Dharavi, which is a huge slum settlement. Particularly if you look at cities like Chennai, we have slum settlements, but they are small slum settlements. You have 2,000 households, you have 3,000 households next to a posh area, right? So when it is like that, when it is mixed, the public infrastructure, you cannot alienate the poor from that. Whatever that the public infrastructure is enjoyed by the rich, it's also enjoyed by the poor, because spatially you cannot alienate and that's costly too. But now what has happened? You have evicted the poor and consolidated them in one particular space. See, Kandaki Nagar has 30,000 households. Means how many slums that you have evicted? Perumbakkam has 30,000 households. Means how many? So you have evicted slum population within the city and packed them in one place.
போயிட்டாங்க
என்ன பண்ண போறாங்க? எல்லாரையும் தூக்கிட்டு போக போறாங்க.
ஓடு போய் கேட்க போறான். ஐயா அண்ணா ஐயா எங்களை பிளாட் பத்திர தெரிஞ்சுறாங்கன்னு சொல்றான். நீங்க யாருன்னு தெரியாத அப்படி திரும்பிட்டு நாங்க வெளியே வரோம். ஸ்ப்ரே அடிக்கிறாரு. நாங்க பிளாட் பத்திரம் நான் தெரியுதான்.